All right, let's go. Stay on Rufus now. Let's go.
I can shoot. You know that. Why you gotta treat me like a kid?
It's what fathers do. I'm just trying to look out for you.
You can't just decide to be a father when it suits you. What about the rest of the time?
Come on, Jack! That ain't exactly fair!
1 minute you're telling me to be a man, the next you tell me I'm just a boy!
It's gonna take a while for things to get back to normal.
Normal? Was it ever normal?
I don't know, but it'll get better, son. I promise.
I'm sorry, Paul! What was your father like?
I didn't really know him. He died when I was just a boy.
Where are you? Go get him, boy!
Go! Come on! He's picked up a scent! Stay on me now! Come on! What do you smell, boy? Let's go! Good boy. There they are. Good boy, Rufus.
There you go. Paul, what are you doing?
Watch yourself now, son. It might turn on us. Soft on the trigger now. Come on. Dead now.
Damn. Come on. You can't be tired already.
Good work, son. Go on now, Rufus. Try the rest of them.
We got them good, Paul.
That ain't all the pack. There's got to be more around here.
This is much more fun than hunting elk.
It's always more fun killing something you don't like. Slow down.
Yeah, go on, Rufus. Easy.
Yeah. Easy.
Get out of the way. Whoa.
Beware them wolves, boy. That's it, boy. Yeah. Jack. All right, we should head back now. We got out further than I thought.
Are you gonna mount back up, Pa? How many did we kill? They won't be after our cattle for a while.
That was some good shooting, son.
So can I go out hunting by myself now? What are you waiting for? Let's get moving.
Hold on there, cowboy. You ain't ready for that yet. One step at a time.
Ah, please, Pa. What are we doing here? Shouldn't we be going?
We'll go out again soon. Catch something nice for your ma to cook.
I reckon I can kill a bear, no problem.
I ain't gonna tell you again, Jack. You don't leave the farm without checking with me first, you hear?
Yes, sir, I hear you. Pa, can I ask you something? Come on, we can't stop now.
Of course.
Were you a murderer?
What?
Are you coming or not?
Come on!
You know... Oh, we could be outlaws, you and me!
All we did was kill a few wolves!
Well, I read a book about a father son who robbed banks. What arm will? That was his name.
I'm happy with my two arms, if you don't mind.
Just imagine it, though. John and Jack Marston, most wanted men in the West.
And what about your ma?
Well, I mean, we still come home.
You live in a dream world. It ain't like they tell it in books. And it ain't no way to live life. It was ugly and brutal.
All right, jeez. I was only joking around.
You'll have a farmer your own. You can read and write. Don't waste your life, son. Don't live like I had to. Load up now.
Whoa.
Go. Turned into a decent hunter, son. But try to stay out of trouble.
John, we got a telegram from some lady friend of yours, a Bonnie something or other. Something you ain't telling me?
Bonnie McFarlane. She's a friend.
Mm.
Saved my life when I went after Bill and nearly got myself killed again.
Oh, now you two's in the habit of sending each other letters. How very nice.
It weren't nothing like that. What's it say?
I don't know. I can't. Well, you know I can't read.
Give it here.
You read that thing out loud.
I ain't hiding nothing. Dear Mr. Marston, stop. Need corn sacks. Stop. Emergency. Stop. Weevils and moths ate entire county supply. Stop.
John, wait! I changed my mind. I'm coming with you. What are you waiting for? We better hurry. I don't think I can let you go off again without me. Aren't we headed for Hennigan's stead?
Fair enough. I'm glad of the company. You only had to ask.
Ask? I was waiting for you to ask me. Have you lost your mind? Come on! They need this corn, John. How did she save your life, anyway?
She found me half dead on the side of the road and took me to the doctor. Most folks would have left me there.
Half dead from what?
Bill didn't take so kindly to me visiting on it now.
Bill never did like surprises. How was he?
Same as he was when we left. Angry and dumb. Taking his revenge out on the world. People down there was really scared of him.
Of Bill? You gotta be kidding me. He was only frightening if he was afraid of his own fool.
Bill weren't so bad, but when Dutch went crazy, Bill took it hard.
For a while, we all thought we'd found something right. A better way to live, but it was just a lie. So you saw before they did.
Maybe, but they weren't. But still kind of a family.
A family that left you for dead. You knew the truth, John. And they hated you for it.
Where did they take you?
Who?
Those government bastards. Where did they hold you and Jack?
I ain't sure. They kept their eyes covered there and back. Can't have been too far from here, though.
They treat you right?
It ain't the first time I've had a gun to my head, John. You're forgetting your marriage proposal.
Very fun.
So, they learned pretty quick what would happen if they laid a finger on me.
Sons of bitches.
It wasn't them or being there. I didn't care about that. I've been in far worse situations. It was the waiting. I didn't know if you was coming back. We don't have time to stop, John.
Of course I was coming back.
You were only supposed to be gone for a couple of days. Why are you stopping?
It took longer than I thought. The only thing Bill and Dutch was ever any good at was not getting caught.
I'm sorry. Wait! Maybe I should meet this McFarlane woman. Well, come on, man. Let's get going. I don't think I can let you go off again without me.
Fair enough. I'm glad of the company. You only had to ask.
Ask? I was waiting for you to ask me.
I thought you'd want to keep an eye on the boy.
Oh, while you were off supporting with cowgirls in the next county? I don't think so, John Marston. You only just got home. That Jack has seen enough of me for a lifetime. So, is she married? This Bonnie McFarlane?
No,
What does she look like?
I don't know. She's pretty normal, I suppose.
Normal? What? Normal like me?
No. Normal as in two eyes, mouth, nose, that kind of normal. Besides, ain't no woman fine as you.
A little flattery. Now we're finally getting somewhere.
If you find yourself in a hole, the first thing to do is stop digging.
Another pearl of wisdom from John Marston. I sure do miss those.
I never took you for the jealous type, Abigail.
I ain't jealous, so much as curious.
You heard what she wrote. It's just some corn. She saved my life, and she was decent enough to me, so I owe her this much at least.
How did she save your life, anyway?
She found me half dead on the side of the road and took me to the doctor. Most folks would have left me there.
Half dead from what?
Bill didn't take so kindly to me visiting unannounced.
Bill never did like surprises. How was he?
Same as he was when we left. Angry and dumb. Taking his revenge out on the world. People down there was really scared of him.
Of Bill? You gotta be kidding me. He was only frightening if he was afraid of dumb fools.
Bill weren't so bad, but when Dutch went crazy, Bill took it hard.
For a while, we all thought we found something right. Better way to live. But it was just a lie. No, you saw before they did.
Maybe. But they was still kind of a family.
A family that left you for dead. You knew the truth, John. And they hated you for it.
Where'd they take you?
Who?
Those government bastards. Where'd they hold you and Jack?
I ain't sure. They kept their eyes covered there and back. Can't have been too far from here, though.
They treat you right?
It ain't the first time I've had a gun to my head, John. You're forgetting your marriage proposal.
Very fun.
So, they learned pretty quick what would happen if they laid a finger on me.
Sons of bitches.
It wasn't them or being there. I didn't care about that. I've been in far worse situations.
You came. Thank you so much. We lost the entire harvest.
Miss McFarland. I'd like you to meet my wife, Abigail.
Oh, ain't you quite the gentleman all of a sudden? It's a pleasure to meet you, Mrs. Marston.
Likewise. Thank you for saving my husband's life, and for teaching the miserable goats manners, among other things.
I didn't teach him anything. I know better than to try to change a man. You should meet my father.
Oh, people can change, Miss McFarland. John and I have to believe that more than anybody.
This is a decent first harvest for you, John. You should be proud. That's good land you got there.
How are you feeling, Mrs. Marston? From what your husband told me, it must have been awful for you.
I've been through worse, and I knew he'd be back before too long. He can't cook a meal to save his life.
Abigail, in my darkest hours, when I was most homesick, just the thought of one of your rat meat stews kept me pushing forward.
Well, about as amusing as a weeping saddle sore, ain't he, Miss McFarland? If you're gonna start yammering about women's work, John, I'd say you might be in the wrong company.
I'd say so, too.
I never felt so outnumbered.
So that was the famous Bonnie.
That was her, all right.
She's pretty.
She's normal. Like I said.
Well, you always wanted to be a rancher. I'd have thought she'd be just your thing. The perfect rancher's wife, if I ever saw one.
I already got a rancher's wife.
I'm only teasing. I like her. And I'm glad she saved your life. Most of the time, anyway.
The McFarlands are good people.
She did blush redder than a shepherd's sunset when she saw you, though.
I have that effect on women.
You've clearly had one too many blows to the head.
You ain't wrong about that, Mrs. Marston.
That's quite a ranch they got there.
That'll be us someday. As soon as we get back on our feet.
I don't know, John. How many times can we start again? An outlaw and a working girl. We ain't exactly farmers.
We are now. Forget that life. It's over.
Do you really believe that?
We have to. It's the only way we'll ever have a future.
The life we led, that doesn't go away. It's never over. You think those government men are just gonna leave us alone now?
The old gang's dead. I did what they asked.
And that's it? The life is proud for killing?
We're back together, ain't we?
Until they decide you owe them something else.
Sometimes I think I was the stupid one for believing I could get out. Maybe Dutch, Bill, and Javier were just being honest with themselves.
You ain't perfect, John, and I sure ain't. But you're better than they are, than they were.
Maybe we can't change, but we gotta try, for Jack's sake, even if we have to start again 100 times. Better than going back to what we were. How's Jack doing?
Angry, upset. He's been through a lot.
I hope he's gonna be all right.
It's gonna take time. For a while, his world was safe, normal even. Then it got turned upside down again.
He ain't saying much about it.
I've tried to talk to him, but how do you explain any of it? What do you say when he asks about Uncle Bill and Uncle Dutch? They were family when he was a little boy.
He hides away in those books of his.
Wouldn't you? It ain't like the real world's done him many favors. He's just been kidnapped. He grew up with the gang. That's no life for a boy.
We did our best to protect him.
Come on, John. He saw things no boy should see.
Well, now we got a chance to make it right.
Don't stop. I don't want to leave Jack by himself for too long. I think we should keep going, John. Today, John. I guess I better go fix us something to eat.
Get up, old man.
Hi.
Yeah. Let's move them out! Come on, let's get them out from pasture!
Don't forget your livelihood.
Okay?
I think we're safe. Thank you. I thought we were done for.
Just helping out. Now you take care. Come on.
The hero returns. They don't know how lucky they are.
Shut it, old man! Come on, let's get this herd moving again. Move it out! What are you looking at, old man?
There's some Mustangs and some such out there beyond that ridge. Wondering if it was worth getting you and going around some of them up.
Fair.
Are you gonna mount up, kid? There you go. Come on, follow me.
Come on!
Why you gotta act so biggity all the damn time? What happened to you?
What were you gonna do? Just look at them horses all day?
Well, God forbid I'd do anything around here without checking with His Royal Highness first.
Yeah, you're real good at watching. That's about all you're good for, apart from bending your elbow.
I can't do right for doing wrong. You're an ungrateful bastard, you know. I did my best when you was gone.
Your best is like anybody else's worst.
Come on. Getting old. I gotta start taking things easy.
You've been taking things easy for 40 years.
Catch him on
Christ's sake!
Stop messing around and get back on your horse.
Come on!
Quick! Throw that rope! Now, damn it!
I see him. Come on.
There you go.
Come on, drop it.
Here it comes!
Little loop there, John! Now, damn it! Throw the damn loop! I see him. Come on. Come on, rope one of them. We ain't got all day. There you go. He's right there. Throw the damn rope.
Stop talking, damn it!
There you go. Ow! Ow!
I think that's enough for now. Let's get him back to the ranch. Let's go!
That weren't half bad. It sure will be nice to have some money in our pockets.
Any money we make's going straight back into this ranch, not down your gullet.
Oh, come on. I ain't working for free here.
Make sure there's enough fresh hay. We need to keep them strong.
All right. Damn, a little gratitude wouldn't kill you. How are you?
Yeah.
Howdy.
John! John!
What is it, old man?
It's Jack. The kid. The kid. Well, I just saw him out in the valley. Seems your tales of hunting got the better of him. He said he was going up to the pass, track down that grizzly that's been seen up there.
Kid can't hunt a grizzly. Thing will eat him alive.
I know. I tried to stop him.
But you're worthless as a lawyer at a lynching. Damn you, old man. This is my son. Anything happens to him, you wish it was you that bear attacked.
Find Jack, Rufus. That's it. Good boy. Rufus, are we close? Hurry, Rufus! Come on! Where's Jack? Where is he? Jack, Rufus! Are you up here, Jack? Jack! Answer me! Keep your head down! Keep your head down! What the hell were you thinking going off on your own? You're just a boy.
No, I'm not. I can skin an elk, break horses.
Come on, let's get you home. Now hold tight. Are you all right?
Yeah, I think so.
You're lucky to be alive, you stupid boy. What did I tell you about going off by yourself?
Well, I go off by myself plenty. You just don't know about it. You're never around.
So this is my fault?
What are you doing?
You disobeyed me.
I was trying to prove myself.
Prove what? By getting yourself killed?
You're always telling me I read too many books, that I'm not a real man. Oh, please don't stop. I don't feel too good.
I never said that.
I just thought if I could do something you'd like, maybe you wouldn't go away again.
Son, I ain't going anywhere. And believe me, neither are you for a real long time.
I'll keep quiet, I promise.
Come on. What's your mother gonna say?
I'm sorry, Paul. Please don't be angry.
I ain't angry. I'm disappointed. Don't you ever run off on your own like that again.
All right. I told you I was sorry.
What would have happened if I hadn't come along?
I don't know. I'd probably be dead.
You'd be a pile of bones right now.
What would you care? I'm just a nuisance to you anyway.
That ain't true, Jack. I'd do anything for you. You know that.
I guess there's only room for one hero in this family.
Trust me, son. I ain't no hero. I'm just glad you're safe. Go! Going after a grizzly? What were you thinking? You've only been hunting twice.
I'm not a little kid anymore. What were you doing at my age?
Bad thing. Things nobody should do. But your Ma and me, we didn't have what you have.
Yeah, I know. I should be grateful.
I'm not asking you to be grateful. I'm asking you to do what I say before you get yourself killed.
It's always one set of rules for you and another set for everybody else. You think I don't know what you did back in the old days? I'm not stupid.
You could have fooled me.
You think I didn't sit up and listen to Dutch and Bill telling all those stories? You think I don't know who you are?
It ain't no secret I didn't get these scars falling over in church.
But nobody tells me anything. You and Ma pretend like nothing happened.
We just want a better life for you, son. Now rest. We'll have you home soon. Yeah!
We stop it. Please, can we just go home? Sorry I made you worry, Paul.
Don't be too eager to grow up, son. Ain't as much fun as it looks. When you're ready to hunt bears, I'll take you.
Try this on for size. Okay, this one's for you. Hey, Jack.
Hey, Paul.
Need a hand with that?
No, sir.
Looks like you have. You know, you're real good with them tools.
Thank you, Paul.
We'll make this land real nice one day. Me and your mother will do our part. By the time your turn comes, hell, this could be the nicest farm in the county.
Maybe, Paul.
Just gotta learn to shoot straight or you'll get yourself eaten by some animal.
Very funny, Paul.
Thank you, son. Soon it'll be quail season. We should have some fun then.
Is there anything you don't like shooting, Paul?
Well, I ain't met the thing yet, but as soon as I do, I'll let you know. You can even put it in one of them books you read.
Yeah, maybe I'll do that. Today, John Marston stopped shooting.
Now, I ain't no literary man, but I don't think that'll sell. People like shooting in them things.
I think you may be right there, Paul.
So, you ever hear talk about them machines that can make a man fly?
Well, sure, Paul. Everybody knows about that. You know they're going to be bringing one of those machines around the country next year for a demonstration? One of them machines can turn men into angels.
One of them machines can turn men into angels.
John! Come here! John, come here, quick! Take a look at that.
Jack, go into the house, lock all the doors. Whatever happens, don't come outside. You hear me? Whatever happens.
Okay.
Come here, son. Whatever happens, keep the doors locked and your mother inside. Promise me, son. Promise me.
Who is it, Paul?
It's just some old friends. Me and Uncle take care of it. Now you go inside and you keep the doors and the windows locked.
I hear you.
Then run!
Yeah, run, boy.
Well, old man, looks like things is about to get settled once and for all.
So it seems.
For the love of God!
You best get that gun ready, old man.
What the hell do they want?
Come on, old man. I'm gonna need you to help me hold them off. There's still time for you to run, old man. I'll hold him here. Best get that gun ready, old man. You gonna pay for this?
I'll get you all down.
I did what you wanted! They ain't involved in this! Stay away from my family! I'm taking you all down with me! I'll kill all you sons of bitches! Two damn fucks! It's me you want, not them! None of you bastards are leaving here alive!
of a bitch!
This was over!
More coming. Come on, can't stay out here.
What are we gonna do now?
What's wrong? What's happened?
Stay inside, you hear? Like I said, there'll be more coming.
Paul, what do they want?
I don't know, son. Whatever it is, it ends here.
Oh, look how many there are. They're gonna kill us, aren't they?
No, I ain't gonna let that happen.
Government!
I'd stay right there if I was you! You wouldn't die, mister!
Uncle! Are you alright?
Too close.
Damn it! I'm a hit!
Just stay alert!
It's this way!
I won't let you take him again!
Whoa.
Stop jumping around! Send out the real smoke!
Hey, come on!
Know who you're up against, boys?
The army?!
John, I ain't gonna make it off this porch anyhow. You take Jack and Abby. Take them and... Don't worry about me. Just get them out of here.
No! Uncle, please! Oh my God! They killed him!
Come on, son! Ain't nothing we can do for him now! We're leaving the farm. I'll watch from the silo. You two go to the barn. Get the horses ready.
John!
I'll meet you there!
on!
We're gonna head for the barn!
There's more coming down the hill!
Stay in cover! Don't waste time aiming, just shoot! Hit something! head for the barn! All right, you're covered! Now go! Go! Now! Quick! Run for it! Call yourself soldiers! Shit! He almost got me! Make a run for the barn! Let's go! Move! All right, you're covered! Now go! Go! Now! Quick! Run for it! Who you boys steal them uniforms off? All right, you're covered! Now go! Go! Last chance to walk away! Now! Quick! Run for it! I'll kill all of you fools! You should have run away! Why don't you go get some bread? Even this up a bit!
Jack, Gnarly, get on this horse. Get out of here. Go find a place to hide.
You're coming with us, Paul.
I'll catch up. You keep riding and don't look back. And don't be worried about me, you hear? Now get going.
You stay out of trouble, John.
Ain't no trouble, Abigail. Ain't no trouble. I love you.
I love you.
Now go! Get!
Did you hear that? Jack, we have to go back for Pa.
Let's go!
Where are you going? This isn't the way home.
prairie where the coyotes wail and the wind blows free. And when I die, don't bury me 'neath the western sky on the lone prairie.
Madam.